When I wrote Think and Grow Rich, the original title of it was The 13 Steps to Riches. And both the publisher and I knew that that was not a box office title. We had to have a million-dollar title. Well, they went ahead and set the book up in type, and the publisher kept prodding me every day to give him the title that I wanted, and I wrote 500 or 600 titles. There weren't any of them any good. Not any of them. And then one day, he scared the dickens out of me. He called me up and said, well, he said, tomorrow morning, I've got to have that title. And he said, if you don't have one, I have one that's a humdinger. I said, what is it? He said, we're going to call it Use Your Noodle and Get the Boodle. I said, my goodness, you'll ruin me. Why, he said, this is a dignified book. And that's a flippant title. Why, that will ruin the book and me, too. Well, he said, whether it will or not, that's the title, unless you give me a better one by tomorrow morning. Now, I want you to follow this incident because it's potent with food for thought, what I'm now telling you. I went in that night and sat down on my bed as I was going to, on the side of the bed, and I had a talk with my subconscious mind. And I said, now look here, old sub. You and I have gone a long way together, and you've done a lot of things for me and some things to me, thanks to my ignorance. But I've got to have a $1 million title, and I've got to have it tonight. You understand that? I got to talking so loudly that the man in the apartment above me thumped on the floor. And I don't blame him, because I guess he thought I was quarreling with my wife or something. Well, I really gave the subconscious mind no doubt as to what I wanted. Now, I didn't tell the subconscious mind exactly what kind of a title. I said, it's got to be a $1 million title. I went to bed. When I had charged my subconscious mind until I reached that psychological moment where I knew it was going to produce what I wanted. And if I hadn't have gotten to that point, I'd have been up there still sitting on the side of that bed talking to my subconscious. There is a psychological moment, and you can feel it when the power of faith takes over whatever you're trying to do and says, all right, now you can relax. This is it. I went to bed. And about 2 o'clock in the morning, I woke up as if somebody had shaken me real hard. And as I came out of my sleep, Think and Grow Rich was in my mind. Oh, boy, I let out an Indian hoop. I jumped to my typewriter and wrote it down, and I grabbed the telephone and I called the publisher. He said, what's the matter? Is town on fire now? It's about 2:30 in the morning by this time. I said, yes, you bet it is, with a $1 million title. He said, let's have her. I said, Think and Grow Rich. He said, boy, you've got it. Yes, I'll say we've got it. That book has grossed outside of the United States over $23 million already and probably will gross over $100 million before I pass on. And there's no end to it. A $1 million, a multi-million-dollar title. Well, after the thrashing that I gave my subconscious, I'm not surprised that it really came over and did a good job. Now, why didn't I use that method in the first place? Isn't that a funny thing? Well, I know the law. Why did I fool around about it and temporize? Why didn't I go to the source and get my subconscious mind all heated up instead of sitting down there to my typewriter writing out 500 or 600 titles? Why didn't I? Well, I'll tell you why. For the same reason that you oftentimes know what to do but won't do it. There's no explaining the indifference of mankind toward himself. Even after you know what the law is, you know what the score is. And you fool around until the last limit before you do anything about it. Just like in prayer. Fool around about prayer until the time of need comes. And then you're scared to death. And of course you don't get any results from prayer. If you want to have results from prayer, you condition your mind so that your life is a prayer. Day in and day out, every minute of your life. A constant prayer. Because it's based upon belief. Belief in your dignity and your right to tune in on infinite intelligence and to have the things that you need in this world. And so it is with this human mind. You've got to condition the mind as you go along from day to day so that when any emergency arises, you'll be right there ready to deal with it.